I'm not gonna sap you with a story of how much I liked BFD, nor will I tell you about how exactly I got this episode, so let's just jump into it. Quick warning. Spoilers incoming. I clicked play on the episode, which was called Revenge of the Ice Cubes, but that title quickly meant nothing to me. It started with a scene where Fiery is talking to Flower about an unseen event that happened earlier, but in a vague manner. Apparently, the event involved Leafy and Needle, but outside of the mentions of those two characters, not much information about whatever happened was revealed. Flower's facial expression didn't really convey much detail, either, showing a bit of a dismal look, but that's just her regular look. The conversation was short, lasting about 15 seconds, and then the opening played. One thing to note was that this episode was 5 minutes long, which was average. The opening was the same, as I remembered it, but it was a bit quiet at some points. I dismissed this, because I know how some clips can have rendering issues. The episode finally began with the announcer doing cake at stake, and relating the votes as usual, deciding who gets eliminated and who stays. But one thing that seemed off was the fact that the vote counter was censoring the number of votes, and instead showed a bunch of random symbols and static. Bubble asked the announcer how many votes were sent in, but the announcer ignored her for some reason. I found it quite odd, but a little funny as well. The announcer says,
"One of you will be eliminated today."
And Leafy says,
"No way, speaker box. Who could have known?"
In an obviously sarcastic tone. This was quite out of character for Leafy, as she was usually a friendly, happy-go-lucky character, but again, it's just comedy. Announcer says,
"It's you, Leafy. You're going to be eliminated."
I found this shocking, as Leafy never got eliminated in the first season, and the character that gets eliminated is usually revealed last. As a consequence, Leafy is flying into the TLC and the crowd shows a bit of concern for her, as she is flying. However, a malfunction with the launcher accidentally makes Leafy fly too far into the distance, and she falls inside a volcano, burning to death in a gruesome manner. This scene threw me off guard, and the episode seemed to collapse after this. What made this scene even worse was that, as Leafy was melting in the flames, her body quickly showed bones, organs and flesh inside of it, kinda like if she was a real, living person. Her screams of pain were also pretty realistic. I nearly vomited due to the uncharacteristically darkness of this scene. The scene cuts to Fiery crying, but fizzing because of the water he produced. Fiery yells at the announcer, shouting,
"How could you let Leafy die like that? You're a murderer."
The use of profanity shocked me, but after that scene in the volcano, I couldn't care less. Fiery grabs a knife and quickly mangles up the announcer. Blood spilled out of announcer for some reason, and Fiery kept on repeating,
"Die, Leafy killer. Die."
As he killed the announcer, everyone showed a shocked expression, as the scene dragged on, for over a minute, as vile slashes are heard. Shockingly, the announcer exploded, after he was beaten to death, killing pretty much everyone in slow motion. High-pitched screams of agony are heard, as a mushroom cloud was heard. I threw up at this point, since flashes of disturbing imagery played during this 2-minute segment. Act 2 began around the 3rd minute of the episode. Everyone appeared in a white void that seemed to resemble purgatory. Everyone was screaming at Fiery for how he killed them and announcer. Ice Cube says,
"You Ember, this is your fault, we're here."
Ice Cube started to blow, and shades of her were summoned and surrounded Fiery in a circle. The shades of Ice Cube sang in unison,
"Drown the flame, give him pain."
As they held a bucket and doused Fiery for his sins. Fiery's screams were blood-curdling, as he melted to death for 30 seconds. More disturbing imagery was shown, but the images were even worse. The last scene showed Leafy and Flower having raunchy lesbian gender. And then a skeleton announcer popped out. I hope that this day will never come,